Thank you. You know, this would all be a lot easier if I unmuted my microphone. Anyway, going back to what I was saying, hello and welcome back to Ed's World Gaming Streaming, episode number 3, and we are going to be continuing our anthology of Fallout New Vegas. I'm going to be hoping to do a little bit more of this as we go along, and maybe getting some more audience as we go. As we all know, we are going to be playing one of my favorite games here. Where we last left off, we had just finished off with Ghost Town Gunfight and got a player home so we can start storing some of our stuff. Yeah, no, I saw that. I caught that as well. I muted the microphone while I was finishing up my settings. Didn't want anybody to hear me pee or anything. Anyway, a couple announcements that we're going to make here, and this is, first off, this is very early in the planning phases, but I love the work that Robert and John do over on the Generational Gap, and make sure you go over there and check out their charity live stream. It's going to be lit. It's going to be amazing. They're going to get a lot of guests there. You know, their last, not their last charity live stream, but the last time they did something like this, it wasn't a huge turnout, but you know, they were just starting out at the time. Now they've got almost a year behind them at this point. They've got a lot of practice. They've made some connections out into the world. So, and I'm going to be on there at some point. I'm probably going to be on there a couple times through the day. I'm going to take the day off work and I'm going to watch the whole thing. There's a monetary challenge involved, so get on over there, and if they, I don't know what the figure is, but if they raise X amount of dollars for all of this, John from the Generational Gap is going to shave his beard live on air, and we all, I mean, anybody who knows the show knows that he's kind of a neckbeard, so maybe we'll get him to cut his hair too, who knows. I don't know about any of that, but I'm going to talk trash to him anyway. I hope he sees this later. I really do. Well, it's late. I think he works third shift, so I think it's too late for him to see that. Plus, he's over on the East Coast, so he'll probably see this back later, and that'll be a good thing. But since I love the work that they're doing, on my birthday, which is April 30th, I am planning on not only doing a 12-hour live stream like they're doing, but I'm going to go midnight to midnight, April 30th. Live streaming. I'm going to get some guests on. I'm going to do a few, I don't know. I think I'm going to do it up like they do into 2-hour segments. We're just going to cut it up all through the day. We'll get 12 2-hour segments going on. I'm going to see if Ignoramus wants to come in and do an impromptu, what is it? The Know Nothing Party. I keep wanting to say the Ignorant Party, but that's not it. So yeah, we'll see if Steven wants to come in and do the Know Nothing Party. I know that Twitch streamer Spook Girl has mentioned an interest in coming on and maybe doing something here. Maybe we'll play some games together. Maybe we'll, I don't know, maybe she'll do some singing on there. Maybe we'll just have a discussion about taxes. Who knows what happens there, but I think what I'm going to do this for charity again, and I'll set up the GoFundMe. We've got 5 months to plan this. I've done some work with the Charity for Suicide Prevention. Oh, it'll be April 30th. It'll be on my birthday. I'm going to go to suicide prevention. I've worked with that charity before. I feel really strongly about that, and I'm not going to say anything now about why I feel strongly about that, but I am going to talk about it a bit on the air while we're doing the live stream. But that's a charity that's really important to me. I hope that we raise a bit of money for there. And I hope that we do get some challenges going for there as well. So, yeah, we're going to start planning that 5 months in advance, because to do a 24-hour live stream, to get enough guests to fill a day that you would actually want to see for 24 hours, is going to take some planning. And I've always wanted to do something like this. I have always, ever since I first started doing solo informational videos, I have always wanted to do something like this. So I think I've got the clout at this point. I've got enough audience. I mean, one person, because of the time that it is right now, I think one person is going to watch this stream as it's going on. But there are going to be 13 to 15 hits on YouTube for this, and whatever replay comes back. I might start putting these on BitChute, because I can get the video back out of this. I can download it up and re-upload it to BitChute, and you know, then I've got more views to go with that. I know there's a way to link my YouTube channel and my BitChute channel together, so yeah, I'm going to go ahead and possibly do that, so make sure that this all gets uploaded to there as well. But we are wasting valuable game time, and I didn't make it to midnight last time because I was beat. I'm going to try and make it to midnight this time. I know I had an energy drink while I was at work, and it was kind of later on, so maybe it'll make it, maybe it won't, but I know midnight's going to be my hard cutoff because I do need to get some sleep, so I'm going to reset this over here so I can read your chat while I am watching the stream and the stream health. I took the stream monitor down. I hope that'll free up some bandwidth for me, so maybe that'll stop everything from going nuts like this. Let me just check a couple other things here. Let me get rid of this. Because just in case this is something that goes along with the processor too. And I'm a little bit later than I wanted to be while I was doing this because I uninstalled a few programs that I think were bogging my computer down. Because, I mean, it was running great before I put those programs on and I put them back on and everything started bogging down. So we're going to test run it like this. Throughout the day, we'll see how many frames we lose when we go through this, and I'll probably do a little bit of maintenance on the computer afterwards. And yeah, it is Christmas time, by the way, too, so we are going to go ahead and be festive about this. So let's go and find our video games here. And I think we're going to go ahead and get started. Once again, if you're watching this back and you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button over there. And go ahead, you see the links down below, go over and check out my Twitch channel and subscribe over there. I'm going to start looking for some mods for Twitch, so you're going to want to get subscribed over there. You're going to want to get to know me a little bit because, yeah, I'm going to start making sure that, you know, the chat isn't the complete Wild West here and we're going to go, so... I'm nowhere near maximum usage on my hard drive. I think the programs were kind of janky. There was a web app that I wanted to try and play on my computer because I like playing it on my phone and my tablet, but I think that was bogging everything down. So let's go ahead and... I'm wasting time again. Let's go ahead and get started. Oh, we got to start Steam. Tune-up program that I used for forever is or not forever, but that I just started using decided that it wants to put Steam to sleep unless I'm using it, so which is good. It frees up resources to do the podcast, but other than that, come on, think faster. It's getting to be time to build something, I think. The chat. Crap. Hang on. That was dumb. On-air production once again. It's a beautiful thing. It looks like we're not dropping as many frames as we did though the last time. So, just watching the stream. But the chat is important because I want to be able to talk to you while we're doing this, so let's get that back up. Well, if you put Steam to sleep or exit out of it for whatever reason, it'll automatically try and run an update as soon as you open it back up. So, yeah, that's one thing you got to keep in mind with Steam. Take two. Thank you. Good Springs Gas Station. Well, Jessica, are you ready to play with us? Are you ready to play with everybody that's watching? Let's do this. Alright, so where we last left off, we now have a home. And we're going to go ahead and unlock this floor safe here to get the crap out of, because this is what we're going to use to store stuff in. So we got a doctor's bag, which we're going to want. Some bottle caps, which is the currency in here. Some jets, some Radex. Let's see if there's anything right away that we want to keep that we don't want to lug around with us. So I'm going to hold on to both of these right now. These I'm going to get rid of. I'm not going to do a lot of melee in this, so we'll just get rid of those. We're not going to bother storing them. Dynamite we'll go ahead and sell. I'm going to hide the grenade rifle for now because I don't want it. Single shotguns take too long to reload. They have a horrible damage per second. So we'll go ahead and get rid of those. I'll repair them down. We'll get rid of those. I mean, this has got a horrible damage per second too, but at least it takes two shots. A lot of the rest of this is, I guess, just stuff we're going to hang on to ourselves. So we'll get rid of most of the outfits here. I'll hold on to the food for now. How much sarsaparilla do I have? I don't need that much. I don't need anywhere close to that much. Let's hide some of that. I'll hold on to the magazines because they're weightless. We'll hide the repair kits because they're not. And other than that, I think we're going to hold on to everything else. Is there anything in here I want to hang on to? I think we're still looking for a sensor module, aren't we? Because we want to go repair Eddie. Let's keep an eye out for one of those. Because I think that's all we need. I've got enough scrap metal. I think it was one scrap electronics that we needed. Three scrap metals and two sensor modules. So yeah, we're still looking for a sensor module for that. Other than that, I think we're either going to sell or hang on to everything else here. So let's pop out of here. See if there's anything else in here I want to loot or raid. And see, now there's nobody in here anymore, but these are still set to owned. But nobody's in here right now, so fuck them. We'll get that back. What was in here again? Did I leave something? Oh yeah, just junk. There's some other cool crap over here. And some of the, like I say, if we were going to do a survival, like I did with the last character I built, we would probably use some of this stuff here, so. And, you know, maybe we'll go build some stuff too. Just to kind of show you a little bit more how it works. But yeah, for now, we're just going to leave all of this in here. I know that there's some mods out there that like to show you what's going on while you're playing, while you're trying to pick stuff up, see what it can mod for you and what it can't, so. Let's see what we got. Hey, I didn't even notice he's got an electrical gauge on the side of his house. See, this is one of those games too where you can keep playing it through and through as many times as you want, and you're going to discover new stuff every time you play. I think the stream monitor was sucking out my bandwidth. I think that was the problem, because, I mean, other than that, I don't see any drop frame notices at all. And I mean, by this time last time we were dropping frames, everything was, and I don't know if it's getting jerky at all because I'm not watching the stream monitor. Hey, you want to buy some crap?
That was a hell of a fight. Let's hope it doesn't bite us in the ass later on.
Yeah, let's hope. What do you have for sale?
Can do.
You cowardly dingus. You didn't even want to come out and help. Let's get rid of the melee. Let's get rid of the dynamite. Let's right, we were going to repair those down. Whoops, didn't do that. I'll get rid of that one because it's crap. And other than that, what do you have? Do you have anything good? Ooh, cards. We'll get cards. Yeah, we're gonna grab ammo early, I think. I seem to remember the last time I played this game, we were running short on stuff. I still got crap to sell too, don't I? Oh, let's get him a bunch of stuff. One of the things I like about this game over Fallout 3, and I love Fallout 3, that's one of my favorites, and back the other night I was playing that off stream, just because I kind of want to see the ending on it before I start playing it, but, I mean, nobody has any caps in the beginning. Well, nobody really has any caps, ever. So, you're really limited on what you can sell to vendors, but they, when Obsidian took over and built this up, which a lot of people agree that this is a superior game, because Obsidian was involved. When Obsidian took this over, Coded Humor, welcome back. Thanks for coming in, my friend. I hope the video is a bit smoother this time. Looks like, and I kind of diagnosed that we're having some bandwidth problems on this, so I took the stream monitor out, so I hope that does help. It doesn't look like I've dropped any frames so far. Yeah, so what happened here was, when Obsidian took over, they fixed a lot of the things that were going along with this, including the amount of caps that are out there for you to trade with, because, like I was saying, in Fallout 3, there were, like, no caps out there for anybody. You have, like, 5,000 caps worth of stuff, and Moira Brown, who was, like, the only vendor you had for half the game, had 300 caps every time, and you had to wait 3 or 4 days for her to restock anything. Let's see, what else do I want? You have any energy cells? Yes, you do. I will take those off your hand. I'll take these off of your hands. What else do you have? What else do you have that I want? The Killing Gun, welcome in. Thanks for joining my stream. We're just playing a little bit of Fallout New Vegas from the beginning here. I'm not playing blind, so if you want to throw a spoiler at me, feel free. But yeah, we're just going to keep going with this. What do I have on my nightscope? On extended mags. Yeah, let's do that too. What the hell? It's only money, right? Other than that, yeah, I think we've got all the ammo that I want. Let's take some of this 357 too. I think that's going to be good. Alright, and I'm out of caps. Let me see if I can rectify that. I don't think I've got enough stuff in here. Let's see what else I can get rid of. I guess my modification is going to have to wait. Well, darn. Oh. Gotta look on my side, don't I? That would help. Alright, and that is going to be that, I guess, so...
Thanks.
Go ahead and pop out of here.
Take it easy now.
Hey, Seawall's in here. Seawall, welcome back to New Vegas. You just finished 2 DLCs. Which ones did you play? Victor is really Batman. Yeah. Well, yeah, I could go out and off Victor and he would just transfer himself into another consciousness. You know what? Let's do that, just for the hell of it. I don't know. We'll save before we do it, but... I love Dead Money. Honestly, I liked Honest Hearts. I know a lot of people didn't like Honest Hearts. I really liked Honest Hearts. Where are you, Victor? Not the big corner. There you are. So we'll quick save here. Set. Do it. Sorry, I was thinking I was playing Fallout 3 again. Oh yeah, those single shotguns I was gonna get rid of. Yeah, we might have to do something about that too. Otherwise, I may be deceased. And he's just got some 9mm rounds on him, but we'll go back and we'll be good people. But that was kind of fun. Just to see what happens. Did you do Dead Money in the Green Hill Zone then? No, I liked Honest Hearts. That's going to be the first one we play. Pretty much as soon as we hit level 10, I'm going to drop everything and possibly go and see what it's going to take to get it. Well, I guess I know what it's going to take to get over there, but I'm probably just going to cut across and do that. But yeah, for right now, we're going to go do the Bison Steve. We're going to tell the NCR to get fucked. We're not going to let them take over Prim because they're dicks. Everybody knows how I feel about the federal government. This is no secret or anything, and if you think this is a secret, I'm sorry, but yeah, no. We're gonna go tell the NCR to piss off. Actually, you know what? There's an unmarked quest over here that I like to do to get started in. So let's go do that. Yeah, well, I don't like waiting to the end to do it like I did the first time I played Honest Hearts because everything scales. I mean, you got way better loot out of it, but, I mean, for God's sakes, everything scales so hard. And let's just make sure, of course, everyone can see everybody else's chat right now. No, I like the Brotherhood of Steel. You're absolutely correct. I think they would do very well under the Brotherhood. Like I said, what was it? Not the last time I streamed, but the time before. This flag is going to turn into a Brotherhood of Steel flag after the R-rated conservative comes on my podcast, so. Are there still geckos out here? Or are they still cleared out? Have they not respawned yet? No, they have not respawned yet. Alright, let's see if I can remember how to get to the unmarked quest. It does. Oh no, I have NPCs from Fallout New Vegas in my chat. Just using their canned words over and over again. Alright, I hear you. Oh crap, I really don't have too many of those either, do I? So I guess we'll just stick with standard for right now. There will not be a PG-13 cut of that. I've actually made a header for that particular episode that just pretty much for the most part says that this episode of Ed's World is going to be... This episode of Ed's World is going to be more offensive than normal. Take it. I'm hungry. Gecko meat for the win. Now, the dude is here somewhere. I know he is. Oh. Let's grab some brock flour, too. I like that. Who is it that, when you were doing Old World Blues, did you, like, load yourself up on stim packs with the Soylent Green? Because the first time I did Old World Blues, I did that. You just, there are empty syringes all over the place. Just keep grabbing them up. When you trigger that hit one. You like that? Woo! No vats. One shotter, no vats. You don't see that happen very often. Well, at least this early in the game. When your gun skill is that low. Men have emptied entire clips at them and hit nothing but air. Oh yeah, I didn't play on hardcore. I've never played on hardcore. I kind of want to try it, but before I do it on stream, I kind of just want to play around with it a little bit for myself. Do you have all the DLC? Did you do the auto inject stim packs or? Because I do like collecting those. See, there you go. I can one-shot a no vats, or I can use vats and have to whole clip at him. And there's another one out there still. My ex would cry. When I was living with my ex, we had like 93 geckos. In our apartment, which was fine. You know, I didn't mind the geckos so much. Those weren't so bad, but she also had 23 various different types of python. And that did weird me out a little bit. You know what? Let's use something else. Oh, cowboy hat's dead. My armor isn't dangerously low. My hat is. You lied to me. Let's do that instead. That seems to be more effective at this point in the game. Spray and pray. Yeah, I don't know how to hotkey stim packs. Is that something for like an add-on or something? I wouldn't mind learning how to do that, but because I mean I'm used to hotkeying other stuff in other games. I do it all the time. But no, I do not know how to hotkey stim packs. Can I reach this from here? Do I have to go around? I have to go around. Alright. Let's play, is my repair high enough? Because there is a tripwire around here somewhere. Nope, bear trap though. Haha. We'll take that and we'll leave the rest. There's another one up here, right? Thought there was. There's a dead guy. That's always fun. Alt F4. Oh, yeah, see, I'm doing this on keyboard. Take some food, and everybody that knows me knows I'm going to take that. Gotta love a good glass of scotch. Excuse me. Alright, that's disarmed. Johnny. Johnny, what happened? Why'd you have to die, Johnny? Why? So this is, because I never played with Wild Wasteland on before, this is actually the first time I've used it, so I'm not sure what it is I'm supposed to be looking at, but learned some bulls and five aces. Guy must have got caught cheating or something. We'll take some of his 10 mil stuff, though. Absolutely. I want that cigar, but... I don't know what I'm supposed to be looking at. Anyway, I guess we'll be done with that then. And the dude I think is going to ambush me here coming up. I'll have to look and see what that encounter was supposed to be. Because I don't know. We're gonna go do. I am excited to expand my geekiness threshold because I've done everything. I've LARPed. I've never cosplayed, but that's something I'm kind of interested in. I actually got a photographer that's gonna work with me if I do cosplay. So I've LARPed. I've cosplayed. I've played video games. I've played. I get free stim packs and supplies from the vendor machine from Dead Money. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, no, I mean, by the time you're done with all the DLC, you are in God mode. And I've noticed that in the other playthrough I just did. So, looking forward to that. Looking forward kind of to see how this all ends once you're in God mode. But, yeah, absolutely. No, I am excited to try tabletop gaming. I've done a couple tabletop games, mostly board games. With some people I met at the comic book store, but no, I've never done any legitimate real tabletop, so. Add to the trifecta of geekiness and learn how to do that, I guess. Anyway, we're doing the Bison Steve. You cannot fast travel when enemies are nearby. I was about to go hit the fast travel button and I saw the red blips. That was inconvenient. And of course you're gonna phase through the rock, why wouldn't you? Is there another one of you around here? Okay, well then screw it. What's over here? Canyon wreckage. Oh, okay, yeah, that's right, because I have a Lonesome Road installed. That's why that's up there. I don't know what character concept is. I mean, you're going to have to teach me from scratch, dude. I don't know what any of this is. All right. Let's go get the whiny, snivelly bitch beagle out of here. Actually, before we do that, let's go explore what is going to be, I think, my... What I usually use for a player home, because it's got the reloading bench right in it. Well, I can't say that, because I usually use the gas station. But I like using this, because it's got the reloading bench right in it, and it's got a bunch of different containers I can use. See? Free ammo. We're going to want that before we go in the hotel. Because, yeah, usually I'll keep... Like, when I did the survival character, I kept all my ingredients in here. I kept all my armor in here, and I kept all my weapons in the bedroom. Race and class, but let me simplify. What do you want to do? Melee, ranged, or magic? Probably magic, I think. I mean, you could always do the classic Diablo and start out with a warrior, because why would you do anything else? But I don't know, I guess I'm a little bit more intellectual, so I would consider myself to be the one who would go with magic. Now, for those of you who haven't played before, there's the sheriff in town, which is the reason that they don't have one anymore. Stripped, well, as naked as the video game code will allow you to do, and his wife. The sheriff's hat, the duster, which has no armor capability to it. Looks cool as shit. Actually, I've seen people, like, late in the game playthroughs, where they've got kind of the cape on there. Let me show you kind of what I've got going, what I thought it was, because I thought that that's what they were using. What quest do I have marked on right now? I don't have any quest on right now. Well, we're going to change that. Magical swordsman. I could get behind that. Let's see. Items. Well, first, we're going to put the sheriff's hat on, because my desperado hat is dead. And of course, I can't repair with the desperado hat, so. And then, yeah, well, let's throw the duster on, because I used to think that when people were all armed up at the end, and kind of the flowing outfit, that this is what they had on. And it looks cool. But when you've got the metal armor on already, it's worthless. You're not getting anything out of it, so. We'll go back to the metal armor. We'll hold on to that. What's in the cabinet? Sarsaparilla is in the cabinet. Eh, it's morbid that I use this as a player home while they lay there for the entire game, but I mean, what else are you gonna do? Let's see, can I make anything right now? It doesn't look that I can. Mainly because I don't have any powder or primer, which we'll find that later on in the game. And sometimes, like, Johnson Nash or someone will have that, but for the most part, you don't get to play with that until you get to the Gunrunner's Arsenal later on in the game. NCR, I used to be an adventurer like you, then I took a bullet to the knee. Is that kind of... Well, no, when I was in high school, we were talking about various ways that we could go ahead and, change the penal code instead of just putting people in prison forever and, There was a kid, he's kind of slow, that was in my class, and his grand suggestion was, well, if anybody creates or commits a crime, and it's at X threshold, why don't we just take him out back and shoot him in the kneecap? That has stuck with me for, like, well, I'm 35 now, so 17 years, well, it's been more than that, because this wasn't senior year, but, yeah, it's stuck with me for almost 2 decades at this point. Ooh, drugs. We're not going to take the drugs, but we'll collect them nicely and get them off the street. Because Jessica's a good girl. We'll take the smokes, too. And the binoculars. Because binoculars fetch a decent price. Surprisingly. Can I see you from here? No, I don't have a sniper rifle, either. Yeah, that was Kyle's suggestion to aid the penal code. Or finish the penal code. Just take him out back and shoot him in the kneecap. He was a different one, I guess. Of course, I also... In the exact same class, we were going to school with somebody. If you've heard the song Werewolves of London, which is a great song, if it wasn't for copyright, I would probably go ahead and play it off on the stream here, but... He unironically thought that the chorus was coming with the thunder. I don't know where he got that from. I don't know how he figured it out and how he got that. We finally corrected him on that, but yeah, he unironically thought that that's what that was. All right, let's take back the Bison Steve. You like that? Like this? I do like that. Thank you for asking. I don't know if I've got my stuff up enough to where I can do this. Take the meat. Never let any good food go to waste. We'll take that because that fetches a good price. Grab one of those. Oh, I'm over a cupboard already, just about. Alright, I guess we'll grab the rest of this. And that's going to be that for this trip. Okay, good. I can get into that. Three or four fat mans with my Esther. I didn't do Esther. I don't think I had Esther yet when I went to, when I did Old World Blues. I got it eventually. I don't think I had it yet, because I don't think... Where did we get Esther from? Remind me. Of course you're not going to give me crap. Why would you? Oh, there's another one. It's early in the game, I guess. Oh, you can get it from there. I thought it was a special encounter only. That you could only get it from a special character. Bastard! Oh, that wasn't right. Well. Let's see. Didn't think that was going to be that easy. I thought I was going to have to come back to that a few times. Yeah, Kamala the cop dropped out of the race today. Yeah, I talked about that a little bit on Twitter, but yeah, that was a good thing. I see, the problem is, and I'm not uncomfortable with having a woman of color go and be president. I want to put that out there right from saying this. And, I mean, anybody who's in my Discord server and watches me play around with the white supremacists knows that I'm not uncomfortable with the idea, but, I mean, this woman's central platform was, if you don't agree with me, you're going to go to jail. I'm going to put you in prison if you don't agree with me. But then we're going to have prison reform, so I don't know what she was trying to accomplish with that other than just some funny words, but yeah. If you don't live in Wisconsin, come up here just for the quick trip, I'm telling you. You're going to love it. Yeah, no. My Fallout 3 character is like that too, because I had everything drawn up to a point where I was getting 20 skill points per level, so, and I just level capped at 30, and yeah, just about everything's at 100. No, when I saw Long Sauce play this game when I first started watching Twitch, Seawall's back. When I first started watching Long Sauce play this game, and you know he got to the end of that. When he got to the end of the game, he was at that point too. It was just about 100 at every skill. His goal was to go and hit every location on the map, and he wasn't anywhere close to there yet. And I mean, that's what I want to do as well, is go ahead and hit everything on the map. But yeah, I know that I'm going to level cap out because I'm almost, you know, just comparing to what I've done before. And yeah, you're at 100 every, just about, you're just about at 100 every skill. Ruby!
Hello there. What brings you to Prim?
Who are you?
I'm Ruby Nash. Pleased to make your acquaintance. My husband and I are Prim long-timers. He fancies himself a traitor, and I know my way around a kitchen.
Tell me about Prim.
My mother taught
me never
to say
something unless it was nice. I should be doing a more feminine voice when I do that.
So, I don't have nothing
to
say about
Prim. Can I pull off
a
feminine voice, you think?
For the time being, at least.
No.
It's a sad state.
That is
going to
drive me nuts as we go.
Discuss it with Mr. Nash if you care to. Just makes me want to cry.
What do you cook?
My specialty is a rad scorpion venom casserole. It's more appetizing than it sounds.
That's probably good because it
the
doesn't sound appetizing
a sharp,
at all.
Smoky flavor, and it numbs your mouth so fierce you'll forget you ever had a tongue.
Yeah, that sounds
it's
appealing.
Perfectly safe. Long as you don't have sores in your mouth for the venom to find your blood, because that'll kill you dead.
I'd like some of that rad scorpion venom casserole.
Does sound good, don't it? How many rad scorpion glands you got?
Well, I don't have any.
Guess you'll be needing to find some, huh? Come back when you do.
Goodbye.
Yeah, bye.
Howdy. You know, I can probably draw that back, I think. I don't know why everybody's in combat in this casino, but yeah, they're in permanent combat. That's unlocked, but it's karma loss, and everybody's got their gun out. So yeah, we're definitely not gonna go ahead and hit that. Let's see. Johnson, where the hell are you? Big Johnson.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Howdy. There's your wife.
Hey there.
Hey there.
Howdy, partner. Welcome to the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum.
Who are you?
Prem Slim at your service. Authentic cowpoke and official spoke spot of the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum. Yeehaw!
Who were Vicky and Vance? Other than knockoff Bonnie and Clyde.
Hiding under a rock? Vicky and Vance were this nation's fourth or maybe fifth most infamous celebrity outlaw couple ever. That's who they was. Prem Slim here can tell you the whole story, if you can spare a minute to hear the tale.
Tell me the whole story of Vicky and Vance.
Yahoo! I ain't had a chance to tell their tale in a mess of years. First things first. Any boss you've heard about Vicky and Vance being copycats ain't nothing but ill-tempered
slander. What do you mean going homebrew?
Fact is, they begun their crime spree 2 days before Bonnie and Clyde.
Oh yeah, the Legion, when you're at the end of the game, is just...
Now,
once you've got all the guns that you got from all the DLC and all the stats for that, it's like,
across the central US, like Bonnie and Clyde did. It was more like a narrow swath of shoplifting, check cashing fraud, and gas pump drive-offs. But crime is crime. They drove reckless, too. Having lived by the gun, well, Vance owned one anyway. It was only fitting that the duo of desperados would die by the gun. Perhaps it was fate itself that accidentally drove them into a crossfire between police and a gang of bank robbers in Plano, Texas. Or maybe they just didn't notice until it was too late.
Hey, Seawall, did I see something about streaming this D&D? Was that something that you guys were interested in?
For sure. All we know is that the crossfire tore the car and both occupants to pieces, and the police issued an official apology. You can put your eyes on the genuine death car just over yonder. And there's Vance's machine gun in the case next to it.
A coded killing gun, Ron Helton. Do you guys know anything about D&D? Because they're gonna expose me to that, and I don't know what's coming. Tell me about Vicky and Vance again. No, we're not gonna do that.
Prim is a thriving resort community located in Clark County, Nevada, right along Interstate 15. Whether you can't wait till Vegas to try your luck,
Dungeons
or
Dragons.
Want to hit one last jackpot before you leave Nevada, Prim's your place. The town's premier attraction is the world famous
Oh, I see what you
casino
did there.
And museum. So you came to the right place, partner.
So what's the difference between Pathfinder then and Dungeons and Dragons? What about the Bison Steve Hotel across the street?
Bison Steve is one of Prim's less impressive casino hotels. I'd steer clear of that place, partner, if I were you. Rumor is the dealers over there cheap, and that rickety roller coaster is liable to fall down any day because it wasn't built to code.
And there actually is a roller coaster by that hotel. I know somebody who lives not that far from there that's seen it, and I know other people that have vacationed out there and seen it, so... What is this place?
Why, this is the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum, Prim's premier tourist attraction and resort destination. Yeehaw!
Goodbye, because we're not going to listen to that lengthy story again. Alright, Nash, where the hell are you?
Howdy.
I want to get rid of some stuff. Not that Nash, the other one. Is that him?
Howdy.
It is.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Yes, sir. I don't know if I have enough cards to play Caravan, but let's unload some of this crap. Actually, I gotta repair down those two shotguns first. Uh, I can use that 10mm pistol to get rid of that. That's already at full. We'll repair that town. Go ahead and get something decent back on here. Do you really need unlimited money by the end of the game here? I mean, once you're at 60,000 caps at the end of dead money. Hey, Seawall joined me on Twitch. Yay. Seawall, I'm probably going to, now that I've got your name on there and I can go back to it afterwards, I'm probably going to make you a mod over on Twitch side. Because I've got plenty of mods over on the YouTube side, but I don't have anybody on Twitch's. So, watch out for that. Really gotta take that laptop apart and everything else.
Still hanging about Prim, huh?
I've got enough YouTube wrenches already. Spamming caps is a crime on Nightbot? That's gonna get fixed. That's gonna get taken care of. I'm glad that happened. Sorry about that. Alright, let's get rid of some of this stuff. Alright. There you are. What do you have for sale?
Sure, have a look.
Alright, let's get rid of some of this. So, I'm gonna hold on to this pistol for right now. You know what? No, I'm gonna get rid of it. I got an SMG for that. And I've got a revolver for pistol, so... Get rid of that, get rid of that. Plus, I got these two here. We'll hold on to that shotgun. Get rid of the melee, because I don't use it. I'll keep with that. That's broken. We'll just get rid of that. Charmer outfit, troublemaker outfit. Oh, I could have repaired those too, I guess. I'm gonna hold on to that duster because there's only one place in the game to get it. Magical version of Sherlock Holmes. That does sound weird. Let's see, what do you have for ammo? We'll call that there. Nope. Not this button. Hit the wrong button.
Pleasure doing business with you.
All right. Let's go clear out the rest of the Bison Steve. What do I have for weight? 57 pounds I can carry yet. So... I suppose we can probably get rid of some of this food, though, too. Let's do that now. Do I have to do it this way without affecting my chat? April Hart, welcome back in. Well, I didn't want to do that, but it's already done, I guess. So I have unarmed for a little while that I'm never going to use. Let's do that then.
Move along, please.
Hey there.
Hey there. It's already worn off, but I'm all the way back up to full health. Let's go play in the casino. So I did just unlock that door so we can go, check all that out. That was the door that was locked that we just unlocked, by the way. So, lunchbox, meaningless in this game. That's all empty stuff. Get rid of that. Nothing in there. That's somebody's hand. Actually, I think that's somebody's foot. Take that to replace the pistol I just sold. A little bit of currency for the road. Let's see, is there anything good in here? Eh, good enough. Lockpick skill of 50 to pick this lock. Well darn. I wanted to pick that lock, though. I guess we'll have to come back. Empty syringes. We'll hold on to those for old world blues, like we were just talking about a little bit ago. Alright. And now we're going to go do some more shooting. That. It'll be worth some currency later. I know you're in here. Well, it's a long shot, but we're going to give it a shot. I don't think this is going to work. Combat, not utility. Yeah, no, there was no chance of that. Oh, I got him. A little bit. Now he's pissed. Run away! Yes, come investigate. Well, that didn't work out quite like I planned. Oops. I love how she just got that shot off afterwards. That wasn't an effective shot, that was just a fuck you shot. That's all that was. Yeah, come investigate, see how that works out for you. I will leave you with a turpentine. Too bad you didn't get one last huff off of it. But I will take your guns and your dynamite. I won't use your dynamite, but I'm going to take it. Because I'm that kind of a person. No, I don't want that one. You go over here. I want this one. Let's see. Well, that'll take care of all my 9mm for a while. Another knife. That's not a knife. This is a knife. Do you want to be decent at melee along with having magic or go? Well, you got to be able to defend yourself if all else fails. Let's go repair some stuff down. Throw a little bit of food down too, I think. One of these days I'm actually going to go and invest in, you know, an actual mouse pad. No, I didn't want to do that. I'm using a magazine that was left over from the previous tenant of this place as a mouse pad, and the front page is starting to come off. Let's eat some of this here. Oh, we're going to repair down too, aren't we? Let's see. Mercenaries, troublemaker outfit. That'll free up some space. Suppose I should have hidden that too. Because, I mean, there's no reason to carry it around. It's 3 pounds. That could be something else. Get rid of that too. Why didn't I do this when I was just talking to Johnson Nash? Oh yeah, because I got off on a tangent on ammo and do anything. Floor safe, locked. Locked hard. And there is a good 357 sitting in there too. Caps. Can I use my 9mm SMG? Does that work? In your Pathfinder universe? Let's see. Get some money. Money, money. I thought there was some other good stuff in here, but I guess that was it. Yeah, it's just mostly junk from the fact that a bomb blew up. I mean, if we were playing three, we could go take these back to the Brotherhood of Steel for some cash, but no firearms. I don't want to live in this world. I like firearms. I really enjoy them. Do I repair enough to do the elevator? I do. We're not going to do it yet, but I do have the repair to do it. So, I can go one of two ways right now. I can go through to the left there and go free the deputy, who is a useless whiny little bitch and is going to die as soon as I bring him out. For karma loss, I believe. Or I can just storm the gates and not do it that way. And to be completely honest, I think we're just going to storm the gates. So, ready, set, go. This guy's got a flamethrower too, by the way. Which your first time through actually comes in handy because you get ambushed by rat scorpions before you have any idea what to do about rat scorpions. But, you know, now that I've played this a few times, I'm not that worried about it. Let's see if this actually works. I don't think it's going to. Nope. Not one single shot. Now he's going to start shooting fire at me. I was doing this mission for the twins. I got the robot running and sending the thing to the twins. Got outside, but I was attacked by a group of old ladies. Why does that sound familiar? Oh, yes, that's right. I saw that in somebody else's stream. Yeah, no, that's a Wild Wasteland thing for the Garretts, because I've never seen that personally. But I know that's something you can do with Wild Wasteland. Alright. I'm gonna rush your ass. Ready? Ow! The first time I played, I died so many times just in this room. Because of this cocksucker right here, too. Hi, Kappa. I'm gonna take your incinerator. And your armor. And your helmet. I don't know where I'm gonna put it all, but I'm gonna take it. Uh-oh. Don't sneak up on a guy like that. You'll live longer. Trust me. What are my choices for weapon? I don't know. That's the problem. Well, when you hear the weird alien sound, I don't know. It'll probably be a staff or a wand. We'll do a wand. It's easier to conceal and easier to carry. No, when you hear the weird alien sound, it's something that they didn't do in the vanilla game. So that's when you know something's going down. And I am overweight. Because of course I am. It's because I keep taking all this crap from these people. And then turning around and selling it. Oh, look at that. The incinerator is broken. It's broken! Okay, so what is a weapon for a magic caster? Because, I don't know, is an eagle orb a thing? You say almost anything, and then I suggest something. You say it's not actually a weapon. What the hell? Seawall, come on. Cleaver. Let's see what else. Let's see if we can get down. Probably pump a few rounds through that and get things done. £13 to go. That's what's killing me right there, is that. Right, let's see if we can. Alright, that'll bring us down enough, I think. Yep. Let's suck down some of this food here. See, all this stuff I could have got rid of while I was talking to Johnson Nash, and I just didn't do it. I screwed myself by eating the gecko meat. What the hell? Alright, well, I'll just get rid of it all, I guess. See, there's no... The way my desk is set up, there's no good place for my drink. Because if it's here, especially if I'm playing New Vegas, I can't see the, what's it called? The radar. If it's here, I can't see my AP or my ammo, which is why Seawall had to tell me to reload, because I couldn't see it. And if it's behind... Well, I guess if it's behind me, it's not so bad, because I'm going to be checking the chat anyway, but... I don't know. I like swords. I can be really geeky and say, hey, baby, I got a sword. You want to come see it? That wouldn't work. Alright, well, I'm overloaded, so we're going to go get rid of some of this crap, and then I'll come back and get the whiny crybaby deputy. We're going to get rid of some more of this crap, too, I think. We got to go back and see Chet. We're going to go get rid of some of that way. It's still dark out. Brush gun. Yeah, usually when I, whatever companion I have on is usually armed up with a brush gun.
Howdy.
I don't usually use the brush gun myself, but I'll usually, like, I'll unload all my 4570 government into the companion and give them the brush gun, and usually they'll pick that up, especially Boone. Boone will just carry that around for whatever reason. He's supposed to be a sniper, but he doesn't snipe. No, I'm not going to steal anything. Where's Nash? Johnson! Big Johnson, where are you? You're not Howdy. Big Johnson. Hey, baby. Oh, wait, I'm gonna check. There you are.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
What do you have for sale? Exhaust all your dialogue options. What do you have for sale? Let me get some of my caps back from the last time we did this. Get rid of the pistol again, the cleaver, all the dynamite. I'm gonna stash that. I'm gonna use some of these big guns this time through. I'm not gonna use a lot of them, but you know, just to play around with them a little bit here. Get rid of the tire iron. Another rifle to get rid of. Clothing. Clothing. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. What time is it? 10 to 10. Yeah, I might make it actually all the way through this time, so. I mean, there's that. Get rid of the drugs, because Jessica's a good girl. I do. I want Saba. Saba, that intelligent sword. I want a sword with a tiger head on the pommel that talks to me. More drugs. Let's get rid of those. More drugs. Sell that. Because I don't have the room for it right now. Not because I necessarily want to get rid of it, just I don't have the room for it. Have you ever, killing gun, have you ever successfully done the reverse pickpocket and tossed a grenade in there? Because I've never made a sneaky enough character where I think I could pull it off, but I read about it all the time. And let's get rid of some of the rest of this crap. It's crap, I tell you. Leather belt. What the fuck am I going to do with a leather belt? That's where all my weight is, right there. No wonder I can't carry anything. I'm carrying 10 pounds of gecko hide. 10 pieces of scrap metal, too. I gotta store some of that crap. Alright. Back to my home. Hey, look, I got all my caps back from the last time.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Well, thank you.
Later.
Alright, let's get back. No, we're not going to do that yet. One of the things, too, to pay attention to with this is, I mean, once you get done with the sheriff's office, you come back in here once, and NCR deserters will come in and ambush you, and then you'll have one other time where you can come in, and you'll lose karma for taking everything because it'll still be marked to own. No, I don't think it's even marked to own. Where you can come in and clean the place out. And then the next time you come back through town, it'll be full of Prim residents and you can't do it anymore. Which is lame because I know one of the safe locks is marked to, or set to very hard. So, I mean, you can't come and do it right away. Even though a lot of the stuff that you can get is kind of worthless for late game, but is really good for early game. But or save and load until it's... Yeah, that's the thing is, you know, I've never cared enough about sneak to where I can build a character that'll do that, especially since I keep companions. Because, I mean, what do you do when you carry Eddie around? He'll play that fanfare every single time. I wonder if Chet's got anything or another sensor module. I guess we're going back there anyway, so let's go ahead and head back to Good Springs. Where we are idolized. Funny as ever, though, yeah. Yeah, I want to do some more of that. Maybe I'll throw some points into sneak this time so I can do some of that. Hi, Powder Gangers. Oh, I remember what I was going to do. Because I signed off last time and I remembered I completely forgot to come up and do this. So we're going to jump up to the cemetery again. Because, well, I don't have a shovel yet. But we can do what I forgot to do. It's not there. Did I get it already? Did I get it already and I'm just stupid? No, it's not in my inventory. I'm not trying to dig, I'm trying to take the free food. Go away. Or is it not this grave? It's not this grave, it's this one. Is I didn't get the snow globe. You found a limited edition Mojave Landmark snow globe. Yeah, I do that with the gas station when I play this game. Exactly. Find an abandoned shack or a room I can sleep. Like, this is my house. I could put stuff here. The gas station in this town is my house now. At least until I get to the Lucky 38. These rare pre-war artifacts are widely considered to be useless baubles, but rumor has it some collectors will pay dearly for them. Yeah, that's... You know, that's another one of those things where it's just, you don't think that you need unlimited caps anymore, because, I mean, by the time you get all the snow globes, you're set for a while. I had to reload out of here the first time I played this game because I had no idea how to jump. I got stuck in a grave the first time I played this game. I'm glad I wasn't streaming when I did that. That would have been embarrassing. Time to hit that old town road. Okay, Bark Scorpion, did you respawn? I heard you. I don't know why I didn't just fast travel down here, but such is life. There's nothing good in there. Should we go play with Cazadores? No, we're not there yet. What did Trudy say? The kind of critters that just get pissed off if you shoot them? Yeah, Brewer's Beer bootlegging. The first time I saw Cazador. Nothing will prepare you for that when you're playing this game. I cleaned that out already, didn't I? Alright, let's go stash some crap. Let's see. I'm going to hang out of that currency, I think, for a little while. But we'll get rid of that. So that'll free up some space. And we're about to haul a bunch of crap, so... Get rid of that, or hide that for now. I think I'm gonna hold on to the rest of this for now. And I'm gonna get rid of some of this. I'm gonna take 4. I think we need 3 for Eddie. We're gonna take 4. We're gonna see if that lazy prick Chet is up yet. I am getting shut down on YouTube, I know I am, just on language off of this. But I did the COPPA thing, so, I mean, this is not meant for kids, and we're doing it late, so. Shoot their wings so they go, yeah, that's what I figured out to do, is usually you want to have something that's repeating, like an SMG or something, and just go for the wings. I got stuck. Coming out of the last cave in Honest Hearts the first time. And this, again, was the first time I played where everything was scaled up. Because I got ambushed by 5-6 of the Cazadores right outside the entrance of there. It took me over 2 hours to figure out how to get back out of there. Hey, look, he's there.
Howdy. Howdy. You looking to buy some supplies?
No, I'm looking to unload some... No, actually, I'm looking to see what you got. Tell me you have a sensor module. That would be amazing. Tell me I'm not going to scroll back up on my chat. There's a dude who uses the F word repeatedly in his videos and he has ads. I don't know if it's the FCC. I think it's just Google trying to crack down on people. I'm not going to lie. Because no other video sharing platform has it. That's the only reason I think that it's just Google being Google. Trying to make themselves look bad so we can turn around and make themselves into a streaming service like another Netflix, which I think is what they're trying to do. I don't think they're out to stay in the... You don't. You do have a shovel. I want to take the shovel. But no sensor module. Let's
give me
get
a
out
shout
of here.
If you need anything else.
I'll give you a shout.
Take it easy now.
Go jack your stuff from your house, because you're over here. I got a shovel, so let's go dig all these up. You have to tell everyone that your channel isn't made for kids. Ammo for a gun I don't have yet. But it's weightless, so we're not playing hardcore mode. See, is there anything else good up here? Take some more of that. We'll make some more healing powder. Ammo. I wish I had something that was chambered in 12 gauge. The Riot shotgun, that is probably one of my favorites. Well, no shit, the anime is for no kids, yeah? I don't know. Is there any anime that's good for kids at all? I don't know. I'm just kind of starting in my anime journey, so I'm not 100% sure. I know, you're going to hate me for this. I'm doing the English dub of Evangelion, Neon Genesis. Seawall and I have talked about this before, and he has disapproved, but he didn't like the Japanese one either. Is Naruto a kid-friendly one? Because I know I see a lot of kids running around with that kind of stuff. Never seen it. You disapprove, somewhat. I disavow. So how do you like that? Let's go back to the Bison Steve. I've got murder on the brain. Alright. I do not save enough in this game. I'll tell you that. As open as this is, especially, as much time as you spend outdoors, not going in and out of doors like you do in Fallout 3, I do not save enough in this game. Alright. Can I pick this lock? I can. We'll get the experience off it. How do you like that? First try. I'm that damn good. Well, I didn't think it was going to be that much experience. All right, 12 to go. Let's see. What do we want to do? Five in there. Throw five in there. Throw the rest in there. No perk this time. We're not on number. We're halfway to Honest Hearts already. And what are we at? Let's do a hard save just so we can see what we're at. Well, we started out at 422. There's probably an easier way to see the timer, and I don't know what it is. Yeah, we're at 5.5 hours, and we're already at level 5. Alright. Ooh, a weapon. Ooh, a piece of candy. Ooh, sarsaparilla. Builds mass with sass. Yes, I see you over there. No, I really don't care.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but...
You must be Deputy Beagle.
Why, yes, I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a predicament here. I'd be most appreciative if you'd set me free.
Well, I remember the controversy when Sailor Moon first came over to this side of the ocean. And how many parents were pissed off about that? I was about the age appropriate range to watch that too. Or at least what they were targeted for. I was like 12, 13, or 14 when that first came over. Or at least the first time I heard about it. Maybe it was here before and I didn't know, but I mean, when it first got mainstreamed, I was 12 or 13. And I just remember how angry parents were at the fact that boys were going to be ogling over these Japanese cartoons with girls in miniskirts. And I mean, I watched an episode here or there, and that was the Deke version. So it was Serena and Darien and everything like that. And I just went through and watched season one of, is it Crunchyroll dub? Who dubbed it, the one that's on Amazon? I just watched season one of that, and it was enjoyable. It may be a little bit immature for me, but it was enjoyable, to say the least. I don't know what all the parents were getting so up in arms about. I mean, Ray had a little bit of an upskirt here and there, but other than that, I mean, girls that age were dressing like that when I was that age, so I don't see what the problem was, but apparently some parents in the 90s did. I hear you may have information on some cons that came through here with a guy in a checkered suit.
My good lady, I believe I may have some information that would prove useful. If you would just untie my hands, I'd be more than happy to share that information I have with you.
You can tell me, or you can rot in here. Sweet Chuck.
Well, you look to be a trustworthy sort. Okay, I'll tell you what I know. I overheard them saying that they're on their way to Novak. If you want to follow them, I strongly suggest that you follow the road through Nipton. There are a lot of dangerous things out in the desert. You won't have me with you to protect you, because I need to stay here and keep Prim safe.
All right, well.
It would be so very delightful if you set me free.
How'd you end up being a hostage?
I must say it's been the low point of my career in law enforcement. The Powder Gangers stole into town at night and murdered my sister and her husband, the sheriff, in bed while I was sleeping in the office.
Yeah, I found them
already. I watched them for a bit, waiting for the right moment to pounce and arrest the lot of them, taking careful notes as I watched. To my dismay, they found me while I waited in the shadows and brought me here.
All right. I'm doing a good karma run. I'll set you free.
Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be making my way outside now. The air is a little close in here.
Well, I'm actually not going to make him fight me, or fight by my side, because he's a little bitch. But I'm going to take the speech check. First anime I watched was Maburaho, which was made in 03, but I'd still like it to this day. But the worst part is I watched an English dub. I don't mind doing the English dubs. I am one of those people that'll, like, play cards or answer text messages or, you know, even write some of my solo video scripts while I'm watching anime. To do it in English dub, it works better for me. I'm sorry, I can't do the subtitles, not with the way that I do things. If I could dedicate more time to doing it, I would probably enjoy the subtitles in the original, but I mean, just for me, I've got to do the English dubs. The first anime that I actually sat down and watched was Cowboy Bebop, which I still love to this day. I've got the full series on my Amazon account. I bought it. I've actually got Ghost in the Shell too, but I've never watched it. I picked that up when I saw the trailer for it with Scarlett Johansson in the movie theater. I'm like, well, let's see what the original was like, and I just never watched it. All right, let's take the speech check.
Oh, Why, of course. I'd never let you fight my kidnappers with my help. Without it. You lead the way.
Little bitch. Alright. I'll take some of this. That's always helpful. I'll leave that there for now. Alright, let's get you outside, and then I'll go clean out the upstairs. Because yours... How they say it? You're as useless as tits on a rad scorpion. Actually, that was who Johnson was talking about, was this dude. Here's the thing. I work different, though, because it's cringe to me. It has more emotion of the character and felt the emotion from those characters' Japanese stuff. Yeah, I heard a lot of that when people were talking about Evangelion. And, I don't know, I guess, like I say, for me, I can't pay enough attention to it, dedicate enough attention to it, with everything else that I have going on to be able to effectively do it in subtitles. I'm not opposed to subtitles.
Well, that was quite an adventure. Breaking myself out of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it, of course, but it was quite thrilling.
Dude, everybody was dead when I untied you. Prim.
What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage?
Can you tell me about the man in a checkered suit who came through here? You did that.
Ah, yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the powder gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you?
Sure was.
They said they'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there.
Come back here.
Hello again. I don't suppose...
What are you talking about? You're the sheriff now.
Oh, no. I'm just a deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
What are the qualifications for a sheriff? Is this guy next Brotherhood of Steel? No, that's Chain That Binds, not Chain of Command.
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the powder gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
They didn't shoot the deputy. I'll help bring law and order back to Prim. Yeah, we'll do
you
that.
You will. That's just marvelous. I'll start thinking up questions for the interview.
Yeah, okay.
The sheriff that was incarcerated up at NCRCF may be a good choice. You also may be able to convince that NCR guy across the road to take the town under his wing. Although martial law doesn't...
And see, that's exactly the problem. And we'll go through that speech check just so I can show you why that's a problem right there. But first we're going to go start shooting at people. And what the hell? Let's just use this. Well, I'm out of ammo anyway. Let's see. Screw the bubblegum. We'll take the Nuka-Cola. And up the stairs we go. Ready, set, here we go. Hey look, more Nuka-Cola. More sarsaparilla. Alright. So the radar is lit up. Got a very easy lock here. And you can tell this is built off the Fall 3 engine because... I mean, they've got some of the stuff from Fallout 3, like the vacuum cleaner, but it serves no purpose in this game whatsoever. Take that. No. Nothing in there. more smokes. We'll take this doctor's bag. I do like that. Thank you for asking. That's very kind of you. Let's see. Pistol, more bullets, some caps, cases for reload, dynamite, armor, food. Another one over here. Guess not.
What was that? Got you now. Come on.
Another one? I bet they're coming down from upstairs now.
Maybe. You like that?
It's like a shooting gallery. I'll just go back and forth over and over again. Who's still with me? I know Killing Gun was the last one I talked to. Sewell, are you still in here? I'll take some stuff. Sewell's still in here. Yeah, no, I know we were supposed to talk mods the other day, it's just the weekend got so busy it got away from me. Oh, that guy must have been an addict, because he's got some fixer. Wouldn't it be nice if it was that easy? Oh, you're addicted to heroin now. Oh, here, have this chemical. Still only pulling 200 for her. Wait. Do I have an effect on me still? I thought the gecko meat had worn off by now. Let's look. Oh, that's permanent? That's fucking lame. That is lame indeed. Oh. All right, let's fix some of this stuff down. Gonna use this so I can free up some repair on it and knock the other one down. Let's see. Get rid of some of this armor. Because I know that weighs a lot right at a time. That is so lame. That. So, oh, that dropped me again. So I guess my question now is, I mean, is there any way to get rid of that? The gecko meat? The problem that I have here? I've never seen that before. Legitimately, it's the first time I've ever seen that, so... And there is a bunch of stuff in here, too, so... It's worth it to come in here and clean out. We're not doing anything on that. Take the cigarettes. You know, it'd be nice if like the cigarettes and the packs of cigarettes stacked, so you get like 10 packs of cigarettes. And then you got a carton, or you get 20 of the cigarettes like that laying around, and you get a pack. That'd be nice. That'd be a nice mechanic for them to add in, but of course it doesn't happen. The king is like an Elvis Presley. Yeah, well, they couldn't use Elvis Presley on anything like that. Oh, didn't do the swallow wall noise. I'll own up to it. I just farted. It didn't get loud, though. Maybe because I wasn't on MSNBC. The suit for now. Can I get up there from here? No, I can't. I gotta go in the next room. Maybe. Anything good in here?
Anybody there?
My gun skill sucks. We're trapped in vats. That's the whole reason I don't use Mysterious Stranger too either. The first time I played through this game, I used Mysterious Stranger, and I got trapped in the animation so many times, I just died from it over and over again. I mean, it's a cool perk, like if you're playing, I don't know, Fallout Shelter or something. It's a cool thing to have on there, but yeah, when you're in this game, it'll kill you more times than... And there's no rhyme or reason to when he shows up either, so... I mean, you're in the middle of an attack where 25 people are shooting at you, and a mysterious stranger locks you into place, and all of a sudden 25 people are shooting at you, and you're on the ground. Worn key. Oh yeah, that's right, I need that. Let's go find some other stuff. Yeah, I checked that already. I did just kill Tuvok. Is Tim Russ credited in the voice acting of this game? Alright, we'll do this floor first. Then we'll go up to the next one. Take some more Nuki Cola. Even though it's bad for it, it gives you rads. What's life without a little bit of rads? Take the pool stick. Leave the coffee mug, because I'm not doing survival run again. I keep saying that. You guys probably realize I'm not doing survival run right now. Probably don't need to keep telling you that. That'll take us back outside. To the roller coaster. It's got a couple more of these jack-offs on it. Take some more scrap metal, even though I don't need it. Always good to have. Oh, this one's actually got some useful stuff in it. You got a ransom note here. We'll go ahead and listen to that. Nothing else of interest in here, but let's go see what that says on the holotape. I don't know, does sleeping get rid of this gecko meat sickness that I have here, or what do I do with that? Other than listen to my phone go off. Alright, anyway, I'm gonna listen to the holotape. Alright, no, it's not a holotape, so we don't have to listen to it. It's just a regular note. Mr. Peterson, if you ever want to see your wife alive again, bring the cash and small unmarked bills to the Bison Steve on Tuesday. Apparently that didn't work out. Because now he's dead. I'm guessing a bomb fell. Alright, which way did we go already? Was it this way? Oh. Very easy. So, I'm guessing that's Peterson's wife, because it's clearly a chick in a dress on the bed down the hall. Open the suitcase. Got some drugs. Jet. The drug of champions. And more pre-war stuff, which, I mean, it's not bad, but I mean, you just got to keep collecting it over and over again, and it takes up space. I'm not playing this for you guys to keep going back and forth to my house in Good Springs. My gas station. I'm an entrepreneur. Alright, I guess let's go upstairs, though. Wait, did I just see pre-war money? I did. I do want that. Not a ton of caps, but that's enough, especially for the fact that it's weightless. More smokes. I'm surprised with all the cigarettes that are around this place and the packs and the cartons and everything that, I mean, there's no option to make your character smoke. That actually surprised me a little bit. I mean, and there are other people that do smoke. Okay. Take the bottle cap. Now give me the cigarette. But I guess that would be too controversial for anybody in 2010. Ooh, stuff. Ooh, SMG. Alright, Seawall, have a good night. Enjoy work tomorrow. All the good stuff. I hope I see you during the charity stream. And that's the end of that. Let's see if I can cut anything down here again. I could probably use some of this food, I guess. I'll take some of my weight down. Let's see, what else? I'll use these, that'll bring us down a little bit. Nice that they have a protection for the one that you have modded to keep you from using that one up accidentally. So, we don't get as much 10mm ammo in this game, but it's definitely worth it to use. Because you've got a higher damage. No, I guess you don't. Well, that's almost mostly repaired, I guess, too, so. That's the one I want. Well, I apologize. I guess they're about the same right now. But that's just about to breaking condition, and that's just about fully repaired, so. And we'll get more damage out of that one. What do the Twitch guys say? Have a good rest. Yeah, that's what they like to say. Have a good rest, Seawall. Alright, let's come over here. Although I should probably go unload at some point. It's really weird seeing all this move in my peripheral vision over next to me. Because, I mean, for me right now, underneath me, that's where we're looking at with the webcam, and that's, I've got a probably a 24-inch TV over here that I'm using as a monitor. I know my refresh rate isn't that good in anything, but it was cheap and I like it. And then, yeah, it's just the game monitor, the chat and everything is over here next to me, so... I know. Jack Stalker and I had that conversation. He rebuked me for using a TV as a monitor because it doesn't have the right refresh rate. Bottle caps and Nuka-Cola. We'll take that. Absolutely. Let's see. What else is there? And this is all just silverware, flatware, and stuff. That sandwich is starting to wear off. I think when we're done here, I'll have a bowl of soup before I go to bed. Take a pack of cigarettes. I made some creamy potato soup, so... That's gonna be good. It's nice, warm, and hearty, and ready to go. I might do some cooking streams on this. You know, I might go back to the food blogging thing. Just for fun. Just to kind of break up the monotony of talking about politics and... Well... It's not really monotonous playing video games, but I mean, just to kind of break some of that up and do, that's why I'm doing this now, is because all I did for 2 years was talk politics, and you know, let's have some fun every once in a while. This guy got drunk in the tub, and he got drugs. And I guess when I picked up the drugs, he had to jump. Might as well jump. No, I didn't want to do that. Is there anything good in here? Ooh, sleepwear. Sexy sleepwear. And money. Money. I like money. I think that was it. Was there anything else upstairs? I don't think there's a third floor to this. I don't remember. It's been a while. I've been playing Fallout 3. Let's double check. But I don't think there is. I think it all ends right here. Yeah, it does. Alright, so we'll come in here, we'll drop down. And we'll go out the back way just to show you what's over there. Oh, that's the front way. I have a second monitor hooked up to my laptop, that way I can actually multi- Yeah, that's what I'm doing too. That's part of the reason I'm not playing something that's fairly newish, that's why I'm playing an old game like Fallout New Vegas right now, just because, I mean, Fallout 4 will not run on this laptop. It's not that old either, it's only 4 years old as of next year. It's an HP though, so it's understated. I can tell you right now it's understated. But laptops are never as powerful as desktops. Alright, let's see who's going to start shooting at us. There are no red blips out here. Yeah, there are. I guess we're gonna do this the old-fashioned way. Maybe. He cooperates. Got him. Take some of my spread away, I think. Crippled. Crippled head. Still. Reuse the mods with Fallout 4. I guess I don't know enough about Fallout 4 because I've never played it. I would try them, I guess. I mean, I'm open to using some of the mods on this one. I'm not using any right now, but... Yeah, I'm always open to try. Do I have to go all the way across the roller coaster now? Apparently. I think this is one of those too tall jumps to do anything. I wonder if I can see the Powder Gangers from here. I know they're over there. Probably not. Yeah, they're out of scope range. My perception isn't that good. It's good. It's not that good. Let's see. 556. A cleaver. Another rifle to repair this one out of. I can jump down from here without any problem, and I guess let's go find a new sheriff for this town. Oh. My weapon's too good, I can't use it. So, Deputy Beagle, little bitch that he is, mentioned something about a sheriff possibly over in the NCR. We actually already talked to the guy once, so we'll go over and see him. But he's going to send us on another side quest to do. But to do the side quest, we get to say fuck you to the government. And we'll see why in just a second. Let's go unload some of this crap first, or see if we can.
Howdy.
Is that Beagle? That is Beagle. You prick. I set you free and you hole up into
youngster.
Another casino.
Still hanging about Prim, huh?
How can I help bring rule of law back to Prim?
Your guess is as good as mine. You might luck upon someone who's a natural-born sheriff. I heard of one fellow what got himself locked in that NCR jailhouse up I-15. And maybe that ain't the best credential, but a sheriff's a sheriff. I imagine the NCR would be able to bring some law to the town, too. But from what I seen, they barely got the firepower to protect themselves.
What about Prim Slim? Could he be the sheriff?
Well, I guess I never thought of that. I guess he could be sheriff, if you think he could be reprogrammed for it.
No, we're not going to do that. It's a fun thought, but we're not going to do that. I'll find Prim a new sheriff.
Finally decided to make yourself useful, huh?
Well, fuck you.
If you can bring the law back to Prim, we'll all be in your debt.
Where is your sale? There it is.
Sure, have a look.
Okay, looks like you got restocked, which is good. So, we'll get rid of the pistol again. Boxing tape, because we don't do any unarmed. Caravan shotgun. I guess we can use that to repair down our sturdy caravan shotgun, which we don't need to repair down, so I guess we'll get rid of that. Cleaver. Leave it to Cleaver. That was lame. That was really... I don't know why anybody's watching this anymore after I said that. We'll take some ammo. Take some more ammo. We're not going to do any 38 special. Because all that'll do is tear apart my gun. And it's not as damaging, so we won't do any of that. Let's see, what else can I get rid of? The pool stick can go. We'll hang on to the shovel because it's useful. Get rid of the rifle. Get rid of some more. Well, we're running out of money again. We're not going to do 223. It's like, once again, we're not that desperate. We're not so desperate for ammo that we're going to use something that'll just tear apart our gun. We're gonna keep the sleepwear. That can go. That can go. That can go. Get rid of all the rest of this stuff, because we got a cowboy hat, and where the hell did I pick that up from? I don't even know. No drugs, we'll get rid of that. We're gonna run out of money again. It's okay, he's got plenty of ammo. Take some more 20 gauge, even though I don't use my shotgun. Figure that out. Let's get rid of some more drugs. Oh yeah, I was gonna add that on there, wasn't I? Excuse me. Get rid of those. Go and get some more ammo. Slugs. Slugs are good. Some 5.56. Seven of those we can get rid of. Oh look, we're suddenly back down to no money. Getting from him, anyway. Is there anything I'm not gonna use? I don't know. We're just gonna hold on to this because it's weightless. Because we're not playing hardcore. Alright, that'll be good. So we'll exit out of here.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Why, thank you. You're a very nice man. But it's time for me to go. It's time for me to fly.
Hey there.
Hey there. Alright. Let's get out of here. Now we're going to go back to the prison. There's no more people in it because we killed them all. They tried to kill me and I killed them back. Actually, before we do that, my messy hair from wearing a hat for being festive. Let's run back to Prim for a second and just see the bad option, the negative option. Alright, so we're gonna go back out of town this way. We blew the shit out of ourselves across trying to cross this bridge. My explosives wasn't enough to disarm. No, it was enough, we found out. I just wasn't quick enough. Now we'll go talk to Lieutenant Hayes.
Yeah.
What are you doing out here?
We were sent out here to hold back the tide of convicts from the correctional facility. As you can probably tell, we aren't doing the kind of job we could be doing.
That's life. What's the problem with your mission?
The mission isn't a problem. The problem is with supplies. Convicts are better armed and organized than our intel initially suggested. I'm trying to get some reinforcements here, maybe some guns with some firepower, but shit. Things are just going slow.
Tell me about the correctional facility.
Most people just call it NCRCF. That's NCR Correctional Facility. A little bit ago, the convicts there staged a coup. Killed the guards that weren't able to escape. And have been ransacking the area since then.
Do you have any information on the convicts?
Not much. They've taken to calling themselves powder gangers. mostly because they've taken to using the explosives meant to clear boulders as weapons. They got organized faster than I would have thought, most of them at least. Thankfully, the small group in town here seemed to have split off from the main force, so they aren't getting anything in the way of support.
I have some other questions.
I have some free time. Ask away.
The attack on the prison was a success.
I'm not surprised. Criminals like to act tough, but they're no match for military discipline.
You're so strong. Prim is in dire need of some real law.
We know Prim is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What do you need to take over protecting the town?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Prim and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
All right. I'd like to talk to you about protecting Prim.
Have you gotten us any additional support yet?
Who did you say I should talk to again?
Knight. He's at Mojave Outpost.
So, we're going to do that just so I can show you the negative way to do this. Because I also remember that, well, it'll autosave when I came in there anyway, but they do give you an out. So, we'll watch the negative way, and then we'll go do it the right way. And we are fenced in over here.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
The Legion can count on that. The Legion can count on a lot of things, and one of the things that they can count on is the fact that you will not go quietly. I'm not going to mess around up there just yet. Because we're nowhere close to ready to do Lonesome Road. Nowhere close. So we're going to run up here. Feels almost like cheating, because I know it's going to be up here. And my perception is decent. Looks like we got a little substation over here. Something over to the left. To the right, rather, I'm sorry. It's just a crow. I guess I don't know what I'm supposed to be looking at over there. Oh, there it is. We gotta put the extended mags on here too. Got it. Biggest thing I can determine from this game is I'm probably a serial killer. Oh. Now, finally? That wasn't extended or anything. Alright, so I've got a friendly marker here. I don't see it. I thought there was another crow that was over there. I guess not. Well, other than that, I mean, my perception isn't tripping. Oh, there it is. Are you shooting at me? Or are you shooting at something else? Oh, the ghouls. That's what you're shooting at. I've never seen that encounter. That stopped it. Let's see how close you got. Then we're gonna change the mag size on this. Alright. Now you can hold 8 instead of 5. That's neat. I've never seen that encounter happen before. What do you have? Anything good? Bottle caps. I really need to set my hotkeys for guns. Take this one just to see how it works. But I know I gotta repair it at some point. Which thankfully we're gonna be going to talk to somebody who can do that. Look at all that stuff. Currency, 10mm stuff, pipe, some armor, some food, which I need to use more of. I'm gonna come around the corner and there's gonna be some more of. So if I'm gonna have to rush them, I might as well just fucking rush them and be done with it.
Hey!
Okay, hide in the honey mesquite pot. Come on. Hey, how'd that work out for you? More stuff. He's got absinthe. He's really living large. That guy's got absinthe. Clothes and more 10mm stuff, and we'll take the honey mesquite, because why wouldn't we? Is the weathered all the way up? Yeah, it is. That's got better damage. Let's use that. I don't know what makes the weathered one so much deadlier, but can I blow this up? Apparently not. The Gamora. We'll go holster our weapon at Gamora. Charming. All right. I stepped on it and it died. This is a good player home too, and it's kind of more centrally located. There's a ton of places to store stuff too. But the problem that you have with it is that all the stuff that's in here that we're going to see does respawn. But we'll take some currency. And we've got a book. I think. Is that a book? I think it is. It's a magazine we're just going to hold in an inventory, but let's go see if that's a book. Because books are different than magazines. Let's see. Gee, guns and bolts. Yep. So this is a book, not a magazine. So this will increase a stat. This will actually increase our guns, but it's permanent. The magazine wears off eventually, and it's also weightless, so you can stack as many of them as you want in your inventory, but this is permanent. It also sucks up 2 pounds of our encumbrance weight, but go ahead and use that. Now our gun stat is up by 3. Nothing up my sleeve. Nothing over here. I'd take the ashtray if I wanted, but I don't. You can hear them. Very easy lock. Open that up. Trash, more smokes. We'll take some of that. All kinds of good stuff there, including more lockpick tools. My god, am I getting hungry. Yeah. Don't order the small sub from Firehouse. It is not worth it. I just wanted a sandwich, and I thought it was the small size was going to be enough. And I mean, it's like burger-sized. Look at all those red blips over there. Too bad they're completely worthless. So, we got one out. Take care of that quick. Hydra. I've never figured out what Hydra is for. I've used it, but it's never done anything. That's the other thing that's nice about this place, too, is to use as a player home because, I mean, even though it looks like the mantises respawn. There's a reloading bench right inside. It's kind of the same reason I use the sheriff's house. Sometimes. Oh, fuck it. Okay, do I have to VATS you little bastards? Do the antenna, always. It frenzies them. Really? You attacked me and you died. How dangerous are you? Let's sleep. You got a dead prospector in here. With a card. Some caps. Another shotgun. Cleaver. Aid. And something that's gonna... Well, it's not gonna kick us over the edge anymore. But we can repair the armor that we're wearing with it. So that's a plus. Let's do this first. You cannot sleep while enemies are nearby. I took everything out, I thought. Oh, there's still something in here. Where'd you come from? Now I can sleep. We'll take 8 hours. We want to be daylight where we're going to go. I keep doing it at nighttime and it keeps sucking, so. Give us a refresh on all of our limbs, a refresh on our health, and daylight hours. So, guess, yeah, because this is a 20-pound armor with a 12 damage threshold, even when it's damaged a little bit. That's got a 9, it's almost completely broken, but it's got a 30-pound, but we can go ahead, because it's similar style, we can repair it off of this, so go ahead and hit repair. Take 30 pounds off of our inventory. We'll stay at damage threshold 12, but it'll be fully repaired again, so. Now we're gonna go see where I also died a lot the first time I played this game. Which kind of blows my mind because it's really not that hard. But the first time you're playing through, it really is. Let's go ahead and see what's over here, because I think it's blackbirds. Sure is. Did I spook the other one off? No, he's right there. Get some criticals, just get some cheap experience. The most part, but for now we're gonna switch this over because there is a hell of a fight this early in the game coming up and I want to be ready for it. We're gonna use this. We're also gonna do that. Well, that's new. That one's never there. So the bark scorpions are like the little sibling of the dangerous ones. So we'll pump a little bit of lead into that. Never run across a bark scorpion there. That'll come to pass later. Well, we're gonna kind of just inch up here right now until we start seeing red blips. We're gonna do it from a raised platform though. I have the high ground, Anakin. I don't think it's gonna work, but let's see if we can do it with this. I can't, my perception isn't good enough. I could do, though. I'll flush him out. There it is. Down. Problem with those, and I died so many times at this point, is there are a bunch more over there, and I don't know how many I blew up with that car. Of course you're not going to give me as land. I want some of Ruby's casserole. Well, I guess we rush it. My perception's gonna stay so bad that I don't see him. I guess I just rush it. Was there only one? There's usually like 5 or 6 of them in here. One of them is gonna respawn after I come out of that. I know it is. Which is lame, by the way. Oh, there's the other one I just blew the shit out of. You've got a poison gland. Sarsaparilla. Yeah, there is just an abundance of that stuff in here. We're not gonna worry about that. Where is New Canaan anyway? Okay, that's gonna be some foreshadowing. But I think most of the people who've watched this already know, so I mean, I'm not gonna spill the beans or anything, but yeah, it's gonna be the first part of the first DLC, which we're coming up on shortly. As I'm gonna start that as close to 10 as I can. I'm gonna go to Boulder City, and I'm gonna tell you why. But we're gonna go into this general store first. See how many of these bastards respawn after we pop out. I meet the useless deputy. Yeah, well, he's an idiot. But we're gonna go ahead and go have a look and see what the happy government way to do that is. We're gonna take that star bottle cap though. We're gonna want that later on in the game. We're gonna take Mayor Stain's journal because he's an asshole. Pugilism Illustrated, even though we don't do unarmed, we'll go ahead and grab that. Leave the rest of the stuff here. What else is good in here? Anything? Yeast! I've never had yeast in a bag that big before. I don't have a lockpick! What the crap? Jerks. ECP? That must mean we're getting a laser RCW at some point here. Snag that. I'm gonna hold off on some of this food for now, otherwise. We'll take the Nuka-Cola. Just because it's iconic to this franchise. Grab the dirty water. I'll leave the vodka. We'll check the cash register, because always going to be a bunch of good stuff in one of those. Alright, let's see what respawns. That's incredible. Kind of pisses you off a little bit too. I mean, when you're used to coming up and being bum rushed by scorpions every time you come into this area. Yeah, we'll go ahead and we'll check all the trucks. I'm not gonna blow the shit out of them because I know most of them don't blow up. That's lame too. I mean, like, everything in Fallout 3 blows up. And the ones that blow up in this game are just so few and far between, it's not even worth it. You forget the fact that stuff blows up in here. Oh, salesman.
Hey there, need anything?
No, I just need to offload some stuff, but we'll see what you got.
Sure, here's what.
Because you got a crap ton of caps. And I want them. We'll do the currency exchange first. You have a crap ton of caps, and I want them. In my pocket. How heavy does it have to be to just carry around 1,000 bottle caps with you at all times? I mean, you forget how much that actually weighs, and I don't know, I was reading a Forbes article not that long ago, and I brought it back up while I was watching someone else play this, but yeah, somebody went, or they were playing this, weren't they? Yeah, some kid went out and collected like 2,200 bottle caps and bought his advanced copy of Fallout 4 with it. But I mean, how much does that have to weigh? That's a lot. How much do you have to drink? We're gonna hold on to the rest of this here. Oh, I was gonna show that off too. Just for the fun of it. Not because I'm actually gonna use it, just for the fun of it. Get rid of that. That's only 1 pound too, so I mean, we're not doing too bad with that. I got beer again. Where did I get beer from? don't take drugs, so we don't need Fixer. I'll get rid of the drugs, though. So somebody else can take them. I have to stash that somewhere. Maybe in my home. Oh, that's a book, too. I forgot that was a book. So, yeah, we'll go ahead and read that. I mean, we don't use unarmed, but, I mean, it might as well. Probably poured the liquid down the drain. Yeah. That would be a waste, though. And, I mean, he wasn't drinking sodas. I mean, they were all beer caps, so... I wouldn't waste beer like that. I'm from Wisconsin. I wouldn't waste beer like that at all. Probably get rid of a few of those, too. Not sell them, obviously, because you might get the star bottle cap, but... Definitely turn around and, That's going to be tied to my chat again, I guess. Get rid of that. Get rid of those. Hold on to the ammo. See if you've got anything good that I want. I don't have anything chambered in that yet. I want that, but I don't have anything for it yet. Take the cards. Anti-material rifle suppressor. This early in the game. Not an anti-material rifle to be found, but you got the suppressor anyway. Carbide teeth for the chainsaw. No chainsaw. But carbide teeth for it. 6-shot cylinder for a hunting revolver. None of those to be found. I might do... You know, I saw somebody use a katana, and I don't use a lot of melee weapons in this game, but I might try just for the fun of using the katana. Laser pistol combat sights, yes. Recycler, yes. Mini nuke, low yield. Plasma defender, it's a defender, not a pistol. Well, we'll grab that. GRA plasma defender, yeah, no. Which weapon do you have all the mods on? Oh, the anti-material rifle? Yeah. Yeah, there are definitely a lot more caps to go around in this game, that's for sure. And I'm broke again. Alright, so... Let's add that. Oh, I got a perk. Or an achievement, one of the two. I don't know how to check my achievements. I'm gonna go check and see if I can figure it out, but. Mod that up, though. Is it in here? No, because then I only see my perks. That's my skills, special, status. The gecko meat thing finally went away, thank God. But I don't see where I see my achievements. Is it in here? Challenges, there we go. Yeah, that one's done. So I thought there were way more. Unless the GRA just added a bunch of. I thought there were still way more, though. Whatever. I'll figure it out. For now, let's just get up there and figure out why it's bad to trust the government. The motorcycle that's blown up. Look at that monstrosity. It's a pillar to peace. It is. What's that sound? It's like we found the NCR. I'm gonna see if I can blow this motorcycle up. Okay, I'm gonna call that a no. Lame. There's a dude.
Coming from the north? Must be crazy to brave those roads.
What is this place?
Outpost. Mojave Outpost. Watching a lot of nothing feels like a big Brahmin pen for caravans.
NCR is the second established faction versus the Brotherhood. Yeah, I like the Brotherhood steel. I always have. And yeah, they were going before the NCR because I've never played Fallout 1, but I've read some of the lore, so.
Not much, but better than nothing.
Any work around here?
Nothing I know of. But if you've come from the north, means you can travel freer than most around here. Might check the barracks. Someone might need you to hoof it somewhere. Just be careful you go up on the roof. Got a sniper watching the road. If your gear's in need of repair, HQ's also worth checking out. Talk to Major Knight, he can help. Provided you got a pen and plenty of ink.
Pen and plenty of ink. Ah, yes, the bureaucracy of the government. What are those statues of?
Those two? Represents unification. Mostly good for shade. Won't do much else when the Legion reaches us.
I'll be going now.
Watch yourself.
Alright. No guns in government buildings. At least gotta try and play nice with the government.
Hey there. Howdy.
No name prospector. Now, the thing about this here, other than these no names, is there's a bunch of stuff out back here that is not set to own. The box is empty, but. You can definitely load up your Sunset Sarsaparilla coffers. And none of it is owned. Yeah, we're not going to do any of that, but... Which is unlikely for a government. Usually they have that shit on lockdown, but... More food. But no, that is all free and clear. Open the gate. come down to here where you don't have the key to open. And I will be, when we get to the end of Lonesome Road, I'm going to let everyone decide what we blow up, if we blow anything up. Hopefully by that point we'll have a little bit more of an audience conversing on it here, but yeah, once we get to the end of the open road, there'll be a poll in the chat as to what we blow up. But let's come in here for now.
Hello.
Caravan, citizen, pilgrim, or...
What?
Just need something for the logbook, keeping tabs on traffic throughout the outpost. Although mostly just in, not out these days. If you're looking for the commanding officer, he's in the back. Although, he's got a lot on his plate, so if you speak with him, keep it short. Also, if you need any gear checked, we can get you up and running again. Once you fill out the work orders and sign for the parts, of course.
I'd like to talk to you about Prim.
Prim? Hayes units are stationed up there. We're having problems with some of the NCRCF convicts. What can I help you with?
Prim has seen better days.
It has. It was a promising trade town before the escape at the correctional facility. Lost a good bit of money at the Vicky and Vance.
Who are you?
Me? I'm Knight. Major Knight. I've been stuck here dealing with these caravans for ages now, but somebody's got to do it.
Not exciting enough for you?
It ain't so bad. If Caesar's Legion decides to push west through Nipton, old Mojave outpost here will be the front line.
I need repairs.
All right then, just sign here, here, and here.
I actually don't need repairs, really. I think everything I got is good for right now. Maybe we'll... because I don't use the shovel for anything, so I won't do that. But everything is either too far gone to where I can't afford it, or good to a point where I don't need it. So we'll hold off on that. Anything I can do to help around here?
Help? Oh, well, you could speak to Ranger Jackson. He might have something for you. He sort of runs things around here. Mostly ends up sending reports back west that aren't filled with the best news.
Can you tell me about the outpost?
NCR border guard duty mostly. It's our job to make sure the caravans can move safely along I-15 and Highway 95. Not the best posting or assignment, but it beats being sent east or patrolling the Colorado. Legion's pretty thick there.
Go back and talk about this again, I guess.
Prim? Hayes units are stationed up there. We're having problems with some of the NCRCF convicts. What can I help you with?
Hayes is undermanned and requesting some additional support.
I'd like to help, but we can't spare any more units. We have to maintain a minimum headcount at the outpost. Orders from the west.
Having Prim and the trade route under NCR control would help the West.
I see the wisdom in that. I'll radio for a unit to head up to Prim and offer some additional support.
Alright, and that's gonna be that. Goodbye.
Ma'am?
Ma'am.
Hello.
Hello. Random NPCs. That trooper is typing on nothing. Must have one of those, you know, the little projector keyboards or something. That's awesome. Oh, I love the glitches in this game. But nothing else here. Ranger
Jackson. Looks like we got a new visitor in the old Brahmin pen. Not many people coming here in a hurry, only passing through. And if you're passing through, you picked a bad time. Road north has gone to hell, and if I let a caravan through, they won't make it.
You sure seem like you have enough soldiers.
Soldiers, no. Recruits, yes. And the Mojave outpost has been ordered to have a standing force at the NCR perimeter at all times. So sending anyone out reduces the outpost's numbers, and would be in direct violation of my orders from back west.
Is NCR sending more troops?
Sending more troops, yes. To reinforce the outpost, no. Troops head through here on their way to McCarran, or to the front lines at Forlorn Hope. Or they're on leave, on their way to New Vegas to piss away their pay.
It's an invisible typewriter, yeah, through. Absolutely. You sound frustrated.
Frustrated? No, I have my orders. Signed and approved all the way up the chain from Kimball. And I understand the reasons. The outpost isn't a Legion target, yet. Not like Vegas or the Dam. But if the caravans get choked here, that's gonna bite NCR hard. Anyway, didn't mean to talk your ear off. Some days, just feel like more requisition forms and daily reports come across my desk than results.
Any way I can help?
Help? No, look, I appreciate... you know what? Yes, I could use the help. And you look like you can handle yourself. I need to get the caravans moving again. That means clearing a path north. There's too much crawling the asphalt up the road to allow it.
Sounds like a deal.
Thanks, I appreciate it. Come back here when you're done. I might accidentally lose some supplies to pay you with.
The bureaucracy. Love it. So, I'm gonna skip that mission for right now. We're gonna come back and probably do that next time we play. Because I am still wearing my work pants, and of course the, the whole thing with... Actually, I'm gonna run up here quick too. Get that mission. OSHA says everything's got to be flame retarded, so they are nylon. And I've been wearing them since... What? 9 o'clock this morning? So yeah, they're just getting to be about the end of their lifespan here. I'm not going to show you my underwear. I never think to change either. When I right before I stream, but... Let's talk to Ranger
Ghost.
You
a courier? If so... This might be your lucky day.
And finish out the,
walking a bit.
What I promised.
And your eyes
and the title. Depends on the work.
I think there's trouble in Nipton. No traffic from there on the roads. And while I can explain that away, smoke from the town I can't. I'm sure it's been hit. What I need to know is if they survived it. Might be powder gangers with all that smoke in the air. If there's anybody left, they'd be in the Nipton Town Hall. Go there. Check it out. Let me know what you find.
Why don't you go check it out?
Got my post.
It's your business in Canada, man.
Don't think I wouldn't go too. If troubles hit Nipton, town's got enough camping spots to rack up some easy kills. Not about to have Jackson bust my ass again, though. Even if I came back
on YouTube to change the graphics and outfits of the game,
it
looks beautiful. Yeah, I would be interested in that. If well, you can't post links, obviously, but I'll look into that. If you have any suggestions for that, I'll do it.
All right. Look at you, all fired up and ready to go. Wish the others around here had that kind of attitude. Listen, I don't want you getting killed for this. So if you head there and run into trouble, I'm asking for eyes and ears, not your life. All right?
Okay. Anything else? Or anything you can tell me about the outpost?
Not much to tell. One of the worst posts in the NCR if you're looking to be anything more than a babysitter. Full up here, but just enough so we can't send out patrols. Gotta maintain a standing force. Jackson's orders. NCR's orders. Can't spare men for patrols or escorts, so caravans are backing up here like a Brahmin with a bottle in its ass. Typical NCR bullshit.
Brahmin with a bottle in its ass. I'd be interested to see that, I'm not gonna lie. Hear any news from the west?
Kimball's Kimball. Not sure which end is his ass or his head. Caravan families are causing trouble.
Man, I analyze politics for a living.
The usual.
Why does all this sound familiar?
You want gossip? Go to the bar downstairs and listen to a whole lot of nothing. Me? I gotta keep watch, then fill out the daily log.
Never mind. I'll be going.
Mind yourself on the plank going down.
Alright. So, because I just sold off to the traveling merchant down there... I'm not going to hit the barracks just yet, but we're going to do that pretty soon. Probably next time we play. For right now, we're going to run down to Prim and see why the government is such a prick. So we'll go here. We'll go talk to Hayes and hear what he has to say. Honestly, and I thought this was the best choice when I came through here, and then when I heard what Hayes said, I'm like, nope, that's not going to happen. So let's go over here and talk to Lieutenant Hayes. Now we just got him extra support. The graphics mod looks like you're playing a new game of Fallout. Well, the only thing I worry about with that is, I mean, this does not have the best graphics card in this laptop. I mean, this was built for sound. This was built for some kid that wanted to play rap while he was at college. It's a HP with Beats Audio. It's 2016 model. But yeah, what they skimped, or what they did to get the Beats Audio on it, they skimped out on a video capability for sure. So, come back here, Hayes.
Yeah.
Yep. I got extra support for Prim.
Yeah, I just got word of that. There's a squad of Rangers standing by. Sergeant McGee will take over as sheriff, and the Rangers will be his deputies. This town will be in NCR territory. This means that aside from protection, the citizens will also need to become registered NCR citizens and pay any appropriate and associated taxes.
There it is. Let me think about that for a second, because taxation is theft. And we're not going to do that.
But those Rangers are only coming if we get your support.
Goodbye.
Ma'am.
So no. Fuck that.
Hey.
We're not going to tax these poor people. So, next thing we did was we found a sheriff in the NCR Correctional Facility, which is what we were going to do the first time, but I decided I wanted to show the negative aspect first. So, let's go into the sheriff's facility. It's kind of weird not hearing the radios when you jump into everything either, because, I mean, YouTube copyright law. Oh, this used to be bustling, but now it's kind of empty.
Need to talk about something?
Sure do. How would you feel about becoming Prim's new sheriff?
Assuming an NCR pardon comes with the job, and it'd better. I also need to be able to do things my own way. Due process has its place. But sometimes it's just a waste of time. I'll need to know that I'm not going to end up right back in prison.
Does that mean you'll take the law into your own hands?
When I need to? Yes.
You have a deal.
All right, then. Guess I'll just make a quiet exit. No need for a goodbye party or anything.
Well, it's because everybody's dead. Myers, a former sheriff from the NCRCF, is willing to be Sheriff Prim if he gets a pardon from the NCR, which means we're going back up to the Mojave Outpost. So, let's zip out there. And what's nice about like places like the NCR is, for whatever reason, the NPCs in the outpost don't sleep. So, I can go in 24 hours a day. I can go over to the barracks and see Lacey, which I'll go do that quick, just kind of run through her speech. But, I mean, she's always going to be there. Knight's always going to be standing at that counter, so... We don't have to worry about time in game. Because as you can see, it's getting dark, and like Chet would have gone to sleep. Johnson Nash would be in bed already, but well, no, while he's in, while he's holed up in the casino, he doesn't go to bed, but.
New face in the outpost. Must have come from the north. So, what do you have?
Any work around here?
Work around here? My check with Jackson in the main building. Or ghost up on the roof above, but watch out. She's kind of a bitch. Don't tell her I said that, though. Might take a bullet some night when I'm going to the latrine.
Anything you can tell me about the outpost?
Not too much. A lot of caravans going nowhere. A lot of troopers going nowhere, too. A few prospectors here and there, but they don't do more than stink up the place. Everybody's backed up here. You'd think it'd be good for business, but most of the traders are tight with the caps. Even the larger caravan outfits.
We're not going to play caravan right now. I want to play caravan. I don't know if I have enough cards to play caravan even. What do you have for trade, which I don't need to do right now? Never mind, I'll be going.
Fine, then.
And she just wants someone to talk to, so when you have to leave, it's... She's sad. That's all set to owned.
Patrol in the Mojave almost makes
And we have Rose of Sharon Cassidy, who is a potential companion. In fact, I will be doing her companion quest as we go. But in order to do her companion quest, we have to start her personal quest, so...
Looking for trouble?
Well, only looking around.
Well, keep those eyes up and turning, or I'll set them spinning. Got no time for gawkers, or anyone looking for something I ain't selling.
Excuse me. Are you all right?
All right? No, I'm not all right. Drinking to forget, and it's only getting me mad instead. Whiskey always gets my temper up, now more than ever. Drinking used to cause all sorts of trouble back west. Before I punched enough people, that is. And they learned to lay low when the whiskey hit.
What are you trying to forget?
Lost my caravan heading north. The driver burned to ash. And they didn't even take the cargo, they just burned that too.
Why would they do that?
My guess is Legion. They're trying to cut NCR supply line. And the Mojave outpost is proof. Got us locked up tighter than a New Vegas virgin. No caravans in, out, and just try arguing with Jackson about it. Roads aren't safe, he says.
Yeah, we'll take care of that.
No shit, you washed out old fuck up. I didn't need a Brotherhood scribe to tell me that.
I've met him. Nice impersonation.
Yeah, he's been with NCR so long, all he can see is the worst outcome of everything. So he doesn't do anything. Jackson won't let me head north. It's not safe. And even though my caravan's gone, my caravan papers are keeping me here. So if you came here for work, my advice? Go find the Crimson Caravan branch south of Vegas. They can help you out.
And that's another holdover from the beginning of the Fallout franchise, because Crimson Caravan was in Fallout 1. I did a little bit of research on that and found that out. I watched an Oxhorn video on it, actually. If you like Fallout New Vegas, go check out Oxhorn. He does great videos. They're informative. They're a lot of fun to watch. And he actually, you know, he makes the lore kind of fun to listen to. So, I wanted to ask you something else.
What's on your mind?
Anything you can tell me about the outpost?
You're looking at it. It's a watering hole without much to brag about. It's like a Brahmin drive gone wrong. Supposed to be a gate north, but you come here, you get caught in the pen. Better to head back home. If you don't have a gun and a will, don't matter much what you do when you reach here, except stare at that fucking monument outside.
That fucking monument outside?
Don't even tell me you missed it coming in. It's like NCR showing its dick to all the East. If the Republic put as much effort into protecting the East as they put into those two asinine giants outside, then they'd be worth that monument. Statues of two men shaking hands covered in blood. Don't seem to be nothing to brag about.
Covered in blood?
I'm speaking figurative. Isn't any blood on their damn hands. Of course, when Caesar comes walking through here, there'll be blood for real. And after the blood dries in the sun, he'll melt that piece of jet-induced sculpture down and reshape it into a bull. Which, by my reckoning, is making up for a deficiency of his. But no matter what the state of his pecker, he's sure giving the West a good fucking.
What are those statues supposed to be?
One's a ranger, one's an NCR trooper. Supposed to represent unification of West and East, or some such shit. As far as those two iron lovebirds go, they've got more spine you'll see in a year from the NCR government.
I wanted to ask you something else.
What's on your mind?
Why are you here at the bar?
Whiskey and me are old friends. Keeps me going when times get rough. Like now. Got me into the caravan business, you know. Had to start transporting water instead of liquor, though. If I hadn't switched over, I'd end my trip with nothing but glass bottles rattling on the back of the Brahmin.
I wanted to ask you something
else.
What's
on your mind?
Any work around here?
If you're looking to sign over the caravan? No. Traders are bottled up tight here. Caravan works up north. Check with the Crimson Caravan, maybe. Gunrunners might have work. Wouldn't know for sure, though. Still, if you got a gun, guts, and feeling like going on patrol, might be some of the soldiers around here have work for you.
Running and gunning sounds interesting.
Jackson might have something for you if you haven't already spoken to that old buzzard. He was looking to try to get troops to clear the North Road. You can find him over in the other building. The one without a bar.
Yeah, Cass loves to drink, so any other work?
I don't know. Seems to be a lot of attention on Nipton. Word is, one of the snipers in the nest on the roof spotted smoke from the east.
Sniper on the roof?
Yeah, her name's Ghost or something. Fucking scary, ooh. Guess it's because you'll never see her till you're dead. NCR and their goddamn nicknames. As if Caesar himself's gonna piss and run if he hears them. Anyway, go on and head up top. Ask her what's going on if you haven't already. I don't much give a shit.
Never mind, I'll be going.
You take care now.
Alright, so we picked up some quests, which is fun. So we've got plenty to do, obviously. Of course, we're going to... It's not going to be long. We're going to be doing Honest Hearts. Otherwise, everything's going to be so goddamn leveled up, we're not going to be able to do it by the time we get into there, so... But we're not there yet, because they want us to be at level 10 before we hit there. I wish I had a... God, I wish I could find another sensor module. I'm going to go check and see if Lacey's got a sensor module, so I can get Eddie going again. But yes, I've got the main quest, which we're going to be going to Novak through Nipton, which, of course, now we got to go to Nipton for a ghost. Can you find it in your heart? Clear out the critters on the road to Avampa Lake. If we're going to do, I think, next time, keep your eyes on the prize, recon the Nipton Town Hall for Ranger Ghost, which we'll go ahead and do next time, too, because we're going to do that along with the main quest. My Kind of Town, which we need to run over and get that. We're going to finish that one here tonight. And Heartache by the Number, which we are not going to do for a very long time. So we've got plenty to do around here. That's part of the. That's one of the nicest parts about this game, is that it is... The main story isn't so engaging that you can't do anything else. I mean, Fallout 3. You're looking for your dad. Obviously, yes, you're going to need to go do some stuff to try and get through the Capital Wasteland, but, I mean, why wouldn't you run and try and find your dad as soon as possible instead of doing all the other stuff? Fallout 4, your baby has been stolen. Why would you go do anything other than go try and find your baby right away? It's asinine. It's ridiculous. But this is, you know, it's just engaging enough that you want to go finish it out, see the end of the second Battle of Hoover Dam. But you actually have some time and some slack to go and do other stuff. Which is good, because there's a ton of other stuff to do. There's so many quests in this game, it's not even funny.
Evening.
It's part of the reason that you level cap out at 50 instead of 30, like in Fallout 3, because, I mean, just the quests alone will jump you up to 30, and that's just in the vanilla game. That's not doing anything else off to the side, just the quests. Alright.
Back again, I see. Something you need?
Oops. I was going to talk to Lacey before I left. Let's see, we did all that. I'd like to talk to you about Prim.
Prim? A's units are stationed up there. We're having problems with some of the NCRCF convicts. What can I help you with?
One of the convicts from NCRCF is looking for a pardon so he can protect Prim.
One of the powder gangers? They've been nothing but trouble for us. Why would we want one of them anywhere in an official capacity?
His sentence was almost up, and he isn't tied to the powder gangers. And we'll take the speech check, too.
All right. If his sentence was closing up, I can see about getting him pardoned. Prim is important to our trade up from California, so having someone there owes us a favor. That couldn't hurt.
Quid pro quo. You can get a peach for that nowadays. I'm glad it's different in 2281, but yeah, you can get impeached for that nowadays. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hello.
So, let's look at the world map. So, okay, that's going to be Hayes, and everything else is going to be in town. So we're going to run over to Prim from here. And I see a non-aggro marker with a quest marker next to it. So that's going to be, I think, where we're going to finish. I can find him. Where are you? There you are. Warming your hands by the fire in the middle of the desert.
Thanks for getting me that pardon. Me and the boys will take good care of Prim. Don't you worry.
And that's going to be, you know, we don't need the government to go do anything. Oh, I got to level up. Yeah, we don't need the government to come in and take care of this. They're going to raise the taxes on everybody. It'll just let somebody in and do that. And, you know, they can keep him in check like Knight said, because he owes him a favor. But ultimately, he's going to be independent. He's not going to raise the taxes. He's going to be one of them. And I don't know where he came from, but honestly, I think that's... I mean, he's menacing when you hear him on the radio, and we won't do that in this playthrough, obviously, because of YouTube copyright, I can't really turn the radio on. I have to have it muted, but... I mean, other than that, I mean, we're doing a libertarian playthrough, so why would we get the government involved and annex another town? But that's going to be it, so we're going to run through the level up. Goodbye.
Watch yourself out there.
I will. Let's see. Ah, everything's on an even 5 this time. That's weird. So we're gonna bring the repair up a little bit because we're gonna need that here down the road. I'm gonna throw 5 in a lockpick. I'm gonna throw 5 more into speech because we need that right now. And I'm actually gonna throw 1 more into lockpick. That way we are definitely over when it comes time to read a magazine and open some stuff up. And we're gonna go ahead next time. I'm gonna close it up here, I think. We're going to go ahead next time. We're going to open up some of those average locks that we saw. We saw the average lock in the Bison Steve we need to hit. We saw the... Well, there's the hard lock, too, that we need to go and hit. That's going to be later on in the game. What was the other average lock? There was another one, wasn't there? Something else that was average locked? Thought there was. Maybe I was wrong. Anyway, we're going to go look for average locks and get those done and up and out of here. We're not gonna empty out the Vicky and Vance yet, because I want to have a bit more lockpick before I go on. But I don't want to have to use a stealth boy to finish cleaning out all the different lockers that they have in the back there. So we'll use the stealth boy if we have to, but I don't really want to. Let's go see what perk we have here. I thought I said we're gonna do Cherche la Femme. Was there something else I wanted to do first? Gunslinger, no, we're not going to do that yet. Fortune Finder, no, we don't need that. God, we don't need that. It's going to be a while before we use companions. Well, we may use companions before that, but it's going to be a while before we absolutely use them. So we'll hold off on that. Bloody Mess is a useless perk, I'm sorry. Comprehension is a really good skill to take early. Double the bonus from reading magazines and 1 additional skill point from books. That'll get you to 100 quick. We might do that one. Cannibal is useless. Swift Learner, 10% to experience. That'll just stack us up faster. I'm not going to do that yet. Retention, skill bonuses from magazines are 3 times as long. Intense training. Put a single point in one of your special attributes. I don't want to do that right now. So, yeah, I think we are going to do Comprehension. I think that's going to be the best one. Cherche la Femme we can do anytime. We'll probably get that done before we go to Honest Hearts. Well, we will get that done. Unless I get something really, really good coming up before then, we'll get that one done before we go to Honest Hearts. Yeah, that's gonna be that. So yeah, let's take Comprehension for right now. And that is gonna be that. So we'll get a hard save in again. save. Let's see what our time is. So we're 7 hours and 20 minutes in. We're at level 6. We're banging it right along. We're right on schedule to be at Honest Hearts at level 10, possibly level 11. But that's going to be it, I think. So let's get out of here. Let's drop out of this. Exit. And yeah, that's going to be that. So let's go ahead and change a couple things here before we get out of here. So yeah, that is going to be that at this point. That was Fallout New Vegas for episode 3. We got a lot done. We got a lot of chatting going on here. Let's get the chat back open as well. And I do want to take some time and thank the Killing Gun for coming in and hanging out with us as well. Ron Helton, as always, thank you for coming in. I mean, I can't take you for granted. You could just stop coming in at some point here, but it's always an awesome thing when you show up here and watch the whole episode or as much as you can. Obviously, I don't want to interfere with your work. Seawall, for coming in on both platforms. You're a champ, and like I said, I'm going to make you a Twitch mod over there, so we'll do that. More Seawall on there on his Twitch avatar here. More Killing Gun, obviously. Coded Humor, thanks for coming in as well. You rock. You rock out loud for coming in and doing this here. I want to take some time and thank Freedom Scoop for giving us some server space to do this. And they're even hosting my gaming content, so that's going to be great. And Steven Ignoramus for his work on doing my theme song. That's awesome of you as well. So thank you absolutely for coming in and doing that. Thanks for everybody who's watching this, sharing. And make sure if you don't want to see more from me, I do solo videos. I'm a little behind the 8-ball on uploading my last video. It's all done. It's ready to go. I just need to take some time and upload it. So I will try and see if I can get up early enough to do that tomorrow before work, and we'll get that going as well. Thank you everybody else for coming in and watching. Make sure you check out some of my other work, my solo videos I mentioned before. I do a weekly podcast, and I'll have the R-Rated Conservative coming on this coming week, where we discuss the news of the week. So that'll be a lot of fun here. That may be changing formats here in the near future, but I don't want to say too much until I get 100% confirmation. I'm right now kind of at 65-70% chance that I'm going to get the co-host that I want, so that's going to be coming up. Make sure you check out on Friday, go over and check the generational gap. I'm going to be there, Christensen's going to be there, Blonde is going to be there, and Avultis and Christensen are going to be having a conversation about natural rights. I'm going to be talking, Seawall's going to talk to him, Jake is going to show up. So everybody's going to be there, and it's for a good cause, so make sure you go in and donate for that as well. And like I say, we're working on this right now, It's going to be something I'm going to do, because it's something that I absolutely need to do. I've got to give back to the community as well. So coming up in about 5 months, we're going to be doing that 24-hour live stream. We're going to see how many guests we can get on there as well and see what happens there. It could turn out really great. It could turn out really bad. But no matter what, we're going to be raising attention for a good cause, no matter what that's going to be yet. And whether we raise enough money to our goal or not, or whether or not we just get a lot of attention to them, that's going to be great for that as well. So check that out, and details will come by as well. As we always say on Ed's World, never take the words of bloggers, podcasters, or journalists as gospel. Find all the facts and draw your own conclusions. Take care, everyone, and have a